In this week's video, I want to share with you what I've learned in my journey from being a beginner baby content creator to now a somewhat more experienced full-time content creator and online entrepreneur. Specifically, we are going to chat about brand deals, how to find them, what to charge for them, how to know if they are legit. Because if you've seen this other video of mine, then you'll know that there are a lot of scammers out there taking advantage of less experienced content creators who are really excited about getting their first brand deal. And as my creator friend, I would hate for you to fall victim to something like that. And after I posted that video, a lot of people were asking, okay, so if this is a scam, how do you find real brand deals then? And this video is the answer to that. But first, I did just wanna say a really quick message. If you are one of my MVP, bestie, end of the vlog club type people, I want you to know, first of all, I love you. Thank you so much for watching my recent videos and keeping up with me. I know this video might seem a little out of the blue to you, and if that is the case, then please watch to the very end because I have a special message just for you, explaining things a little bit. Anyway, for most of you, that probably won't apply, but if you know what I'm talking about, just watch to the end or look for the time code in the description where I mention that special message and I'll see you there. First though, get out your pen and paper and let's get into it. This is the ultimate guide to brand deals for beginners. So the first thing that you need to consider when you are trying to get brand deals as a beginner creator is exactly what your niche is and who your audience is. AKA, you need to get clear on what you offer. To understand why, let's just talk really quickly about why brands like to work with influencers, or in other words, like to do sponsored posts or brand deals. Brands like working with influencers because, for one, they can often reach a really niche target audience through the influencer they're working with. Remember, brands can run Instagram ads too. They can run Facebook ads or YouTube ads or whatever, but obviously when they're using those tools, they're limited to targeting whatever those platforms allow them to, which, to be fair, does get really specific, like specific location, ages, interests, etc. But as a content creator, you offer an even more niche audience that may be more likely to want to purchase from the company. The second reason why brands like to work with influencers is because audiences trust their favorite creators way more than they're gonna trust an Instagram ad. And so when we think about, okay, this is what companies are looking for, how can we offer that as content creators? So you need to have a specific audience, and obviously you need your audience to trust you. Those are the two kind of value propositions that content creators have when it comes to approaching brands to work with them. And so if we're gonna work backwards from there, basically what that means for you is you gotta make sure that you have some kind of value add for a potential audience, especially if you're just starting to grow now, or maybe you have a small audience and you wanna expand it. What are people following you for? What's the general theme or subject matter that you provide to your audience? And what kind of person are you trying to create for? These are all the questions that you need to ask yourself before we even get to the point of you trying to reach out to brands or like get sponsored posts. To test if you might be ready to start making pitches to brands, I would recommend trying to write down a little elevator speech, so maybe like a 30-second or less little promo about who you are, who you serve, and what kind of content you create. And if you're able to do that really concisely, like in a few sentences, that means you're really clear on what your content's about and who you're talking to. If you're struggling to come up with that elevator pitch, then you might need to focus a little bit more on your content and your overall strategy as a creator before you start worrying about getting paid brand deals. Okay, so you're clear on who you're creating content for and what your content is about. Now you're ready to move on to the next step. Okay, the next step is setting your prices. And I know this is something that a lot of beginner content creators really struggle with, and they don't really know where to start. I know a lot of people go to Social Blade or other websites where you can kind of sync it with your Instagram profile or whatever, and then it'll pop up based on your like engagement rate and your number of followers, how much they think you could charge for a post. Honestly, I would recommend completely ignoring that, because in my experience as a small creator, I would do that and it would literally tell me I could charge like $12 for an Instagram post. This is my golden rule when it comes to what I think content creators should be charging for their branded content. It needs to feel worthwhile for you. I know it can be hard when you're small and you really just wanna break into the industry, so you think that you need to provide a really budget option or undercut other creators. But in my experience, and I have done a lot of different brand deals, some of them that I felt better about than others, if I'm totally honest with you. And there have been times when I have really, really felt regretful about taking on a brand deal because I gave them a really good price so that I could get the gig, and then it ended up being a ton more work than I thought it would be. And then I just felt resentful about even having to work with them. And it really doesn't feel good to be recommending a brand to your audience if you feel resentful about working with them. Because by the end of the project, you're not gonna have any respect for that brand anymore, and then it just feels totally inauthentic to have this video live on your channel or this post on your Instagram page talking about how much you love them. And so that's why I think it's so important that whatever your price might be, you feel happy to be getting paid that, and you don't feel like, oh, I really should have asked for more, or oh, I'm really putting more work into this than they're paying me for. And so even if you think that means that you might give them a price and the brand might say, oh, never mind, we don't have the budget, or ghost you or whatever, you still need to say that price, because if you give them a lower price and they say yes, you're gonna end up hating your life later. Okay, so that's kind of the philosophical side to it, but like tangibly, what does that mean, right? Like how much are you actually trying to charge? Well, to be totally honest with you, which you know, I like to be. My first ever brand deal I did on YouTube when I had like 2,500 subscribers, and I charged the brand, I think like $800 US. And I live in Canada, so that's like more Canadian dollars for that video. And I think that video maybe got 1,500 views or something. So honestly, I feel a little bit bad for that. But the point is, they paid me. And I really do think that the labor that I put into that video warranted that payment. See, the thing is, I got my start as a freelance videographer. So at the time, I was charging for brand deals based on what I would charge a typical client to make a promo video for them. So I thought about how many hours is this gonna take me, you know, the cost of my equipment, all of the kind of stuff that as a business owner you consider when you are creating your prices. That's how I created the prices for my media kit, for like the brand deals I was trying to get. So rather than just thinking about what are other people charging, or what's the industry standard, or what are brands willing to pay, think about the cost of your equipment, the cost of your time, how much time you think it's gonna take you to create these things as a base rate. And then I would encourage you to add on top of that whatever value you think you bring with your audience and the engagement they have with you. And as a general rule, I would honestly say never do a brand deal for less than $100. I think if you're getting paid less than that, it's not really worth it to even charge somebody. I know that might sound ridiculous if you're somebody who's just getting started and you're like, oh, I'd love 50 bucks here and there. But seriously, people out in the world of influencer marketing are not gonna expect to pay anybody less than $100 for any kind of content, whether that's an Instagram story shout out, a feed post, whatever it might be. So anyway, I wish I could give you like specific numbers, but it's really gonna depend on all of the factors that I just talked about. But the number one thing you need to remember is, does it feel worthwhile to me? Because the last thing you ever want is to end up feeling resentful about doing a sponsored piece of content. One way that I think that you can increase your prices is by increasing your skill set and therefore the quality of content that you're creating, which is where the sponsor of this week's video, Skillshare, comes in. If you want to improve your photography, video editing, or caption writing skills, you can learn about all of these topics and more from the comfort of your couch on Skillshare. Skillshare is an online learning community that offers thousands of inspiring classes for creative and curious people on topics including design, photography, video editing, social media marketing, and more. For example, if you're interested in expanding your content creation into the world of TikTok, I would highly recommend checking out Taylor Lorenz's course, Mastering TikTok. Stop scrolling and post your first TikTok. The first 1,000 of my subscribers to click the link in the description will get a 1-month free trial of Skillshare so you can explore your creativity and learn something new. For this section of the video, I want to show you my media kit. So I'll show you what I charge for brand deals and how I've laid everything out. Because now that you've thought about your value add and how much you're gonna charge, the next step is to make a media kit, which you can send out when you write pitches to brands that you want to work with. Oh, hi there, Hosier desktop background. I am nothing if not a fangirl at heart. This is what my media kit looks like now. So basically the first page is just a nice brand photo of me. So I got headshots done about a year ago, actually, and it's just a cute pic of me. What can I say? It says Katie Steckly Media Kit, and then I have a little bit of an intro here where I talk about myself, my audience. You know, I say they're primarily women who are aged 18 to 35, based in the US. This is the kind of demographic information that brands are really curious about. So that's the first page, just like a couple of sentences about who you are and who your audience is. This is a callback to earlier in the video when I told you to come up with your elevator pitch. That's where you're gonna put it. Then basically scrolling down, I've just got this kind of two column setup where I have another photo of me and then my pricing. So I basically just offer three different kinds of brand deals. Basically here, I've got my brand integration, which is what you just saw a couple minutes ago. I'll be real with you, which is basically just like a 45 second ad spot. It's not like necessarily the whole video is about it. It's just kind of sliced into a video. And then I've got an example linked, an Instagram feature, another example linked, and then basically a combo where they can get both. Next, you want to include some of the most important stats about your different platforms. So for me, YouTube and Instagram are obviously the biggest ones. I could add in my TikTok here, but I've also got my email list. And again, I'm not including screenshots from any of these insights dashboards. I've just kind of summarized how many times do I post, how many views do I generally get when I post, and how long are people watching it for. And so on Instagram, that translates to how many times I post a week. Again, this needs to get changed. And then what the engagement rate tends to be. All that kind of stuff. I mean, you can see it, and it's going to depend on what platforms you're spending the most time on. So maybe for you, it would actually be like a podcast and your Instagram, or maybe it's just your Instagram, whatever. I think this page is a really nice, concise way of including, here's what I charge for posting, and also here's what you can expect from the content that we're going to post together. You see how often I'm posting other stuff and what kind of engagement rate you can kind of expect to get. And then my final page is just another nice photo of me with a little tagline, inspiring growing creators, which is one of the philosophies of my channel, I would say. And then I kind of took a chance here to write a little bit more about me and the value add that I provide. So I talk about that YouTube is a really good investment because it's evergreen. For example, one time I did a brand deal and I was really disappointed because the video only got like a few hundred views in the first week. And I was like, oh my gosh, they're gonna be so mad about this. But now, almost like a year later, maybe like 9 months later, the video is in my like top 20 videos of all time because people searched for it and eventually it got watched and it was a good pairing with some other videos on my channel. So that's kind of the point of this little paragraph. And then again, I just highlight that I was a freelance videographer. I'm very professional when it comes to my delivery style, the equipment that I'm using, the quality of my videos, just to kind of make that final pitch of like, here's why these prices are worth it. And then like little information about how to book with me, which they would kind of already know because normally we're emailing at this point. So yeah, you get the point. That's what a media kit can look like. And that's what I would recommend including in yours. You can make this in Canva, Pages, Google Docs, whatever. And once you have this, then it's time to start emailing the brands that you want to work with and pitching yourself to them. This video is getting kind of long, so I'm not going to go super in depth on how to pitch, but I do actually have a free brand deal pitch template up on my website. So I'll link that in the description. You can go and download that and basically just modify it. You know, obviously change the company name and the details about who you are. And then you can start sending that email out with your media kit as an attachment. If you're serious about this, I would recommend making a big list of all the brands that you'd like to work with. That's something that I've done in the past, and kind of keep a spreadsheet going where you track, have you emailed them? Did you get a response? What was that response? And you can kind of start to make a bit of a sales process out of approaching potential brands that you want to work with. And that's pretty much the rundown of what I've learned over the past several years of being a professional content creator online, of how to work with brands and get brand deals. There's obviously an entire world of like having a management team or working with a network or whatever it might be. I personally don't have a ton of experience with that because I've always been a pretty entrepreneurial minded creator, and I like to DIY stuff. And I've just always found like I can write a pitch, I can advocate for myself, I can send my own media kit out, and I don't mind negotiating prices for myself. I know a lot of people kind of struggle with that. They don't like to have to argue for their own worth, but as a freelancer, as somebody who's a business owner that's constantly negotiating prices with clients, that kind of comes more naturally to me. So anyway, there's the whole world of management out there that you can look into elsewhere, because I don't have experience with it. But I can tell you that you don't need to feel like you need to get management to be a professional influencer. You can get lots of brand deals and be very successful completely on your own, or with, you know, an assistant or somebody that you might hire. So anyway, I just want to encourage you that no matter how few followers you feel like you have right now, you do have a message to share, and you have an audience that cares about what you're posting about, and you've got high quality content to offer. So you're ready to start reaching out to brands. Just make sure that you look for ones that align with who your audience is, and maybe start pitching to smaller companies if you've got a smaller audience at the moment, and then kind of grow who you're reaching out to as your audience grows as well. All right, and now for my promise section for you, my end of the vlog club, my besties. You might be a little bit confused by this video, and I wanted to honor that and just kind of chat with you one-on-one about what's going on over here. A few months back, actually wearing the same t-shirt, I'm pretty sure, I made some bold claims about where I was going with this channel and how I was about to turn my world upside down and just take a completely new direction with my presence online and the content that I'm making. At the time, I really, really believed that that was going to be what made me happy. And to be totally transparent with you, this past year has been the hardest year for me in terms of my mental health. And I've spent probably a good 7 to 8 months of this year feeling the most burnt out that I've ever felt. And so through the desperation of just feeling this complete and utter burnout to the point where I could hardly bring myself to work day in, day out, I was looking for solutions where I could change my life overnight and completely go in a new direction that would cure all these problems that I've been dealing with. But I've realized after kind of taking that route for 3 months, and I really, really appreciate all of you supported me during that time when obviously, you know, like the views are really low. There's very few of you who are part of this exclusive club. I just have realized that doing that huge switch to something totally different wasn't necessarily going to cure my depression, burnout, whatever. So I guess this is me saying that I'm like trying again. I don't know. Honestly, I felt really almost embarrassed about coming back to this subject area, even though like I do care about it. This has been my daily work even since I changed the kind of videos that I'm making. Like I still run Creatorly. I do social media marketing like every day, but I felt almost embarrassed to talk about it again because I felt like I was kind of coming back to YouTube with my tail between my legs. Like, okay, I tried to be this like cute and fun lifestyle girly, but I'll just go back to my social media tips because clearly that's all they want from me. And I don't want to have that vibe. Really what inspired me to come back to this is I actually recorded a podcast on a similar topic to this video, and I was so excited about it. And I really am passionate about helping other creators also be able to make a living doing what they love. And I thought this would make a really great YouTube video as well. And then I was like, oh, but you can't make that video because you don't share that kind of content anymore. And so what this truly is now is another chapter. I know I tried to open a new chapter about 3 months ago, but now I'm saying I need to stop limiting myself either by telling myself I can only do Instagram tips or only do lifestyle content, but instead allow myself to make the videos that I think will encourage you and also are things that I'm passionate about talking about. And so that could be any of these things. I think a big part of what pushed me to totally walking away from the Instagram tips world entirely over the summer was partially the pressure that I felt to always be this shiny, 100% perfect gold star example of what an online presence is supposed to look like. I really felt like if I was giving tips about Instagram, my Instagram had to be perfect. And it's very obvious that my Instagram is not. But I think that's honestly the case about anyone. Like, I know from a logical perspective, nobody's perfect, but I still really, really felt that pressure. And now I'm just trying to come at this again from a perspective of, instead of being this absolute authority expert that's telling you exactly what you should do, I just want to be a friend to you along this journey of being a content creator. I just want to share my knowledge, share my experience, and also share with you that I experiment and I don't always get it right. I honestly don't think that anyone has a perfect understanding of these algorithms that we're always trying to figure out, because if they did, they would have billions of followers, have a 100% engagement rate, and nobody has that. And also, I feel like it's been so clear to me the irony that the coaches and the gurus on all of these platforms, they're never the biggest creators on any of these places that we consume content. Celebrities or entertainers are. So that's just to say, coaches and gurus, we don't know everything. We are just experimenting and sharing our findings with other people. And I just so badly want to come back into the space being honest about that, because I hate this feeling of like, I've got all these secrets that you need to pay me to find out. No, I hardly know what I'm doing. I'm just out here trying stuff and then reporting back to you about how it goes. What I'm really trying to say here, my good friend, is I'm sorry for being a little bit off the wall. I know I can be kind of all over the place. Consistency has always been my biggest struggle because I'm such a big idea girl. I love coming up with new ideas and then I want to dive in and change my whole world overnight and I'll never be the same. Goodbye, old Katie. And I know that can be kind of hard to witness or hard to follow sometimes. So anyway, just know that, like, I know and I'm working on it. I really just want to be here on this channel and share tidbits of things that I've learned in my 10 plus years as a content creator and encourage you on your journey of also making content for the internet and building community and sharing knowledge and finding friendship. So thank you for watching, my dear end of the vlog club. You have no idea how much your support and comments have meant to me over this past year, honestly, as I've really struggled with my mental health and burnout and trying to find purpose on here. And I can't wait to continue making videos for you, hopefully from a more honest place where I'm not either trying to pretend to be this perfect Instagram guru or pretend to be this have my whole shit together lifestyle girly like I was experimenting with over the summer. I just want to be me. And sometimes that means sharing my advice around social media marketing and content creation. And sometimes that might mean sharing a vlog or something about personal development or whatever. So that's where we're at. I understand if you've lost your trust in me to a certain extent, because I am all over the place. I've lost my trust in me a little bit, but we're here. We're trying our best. I've talked for a really long time. This was meant to be a very short message to you. So I'll stop there and say thank you again so much for watching. I hope you continue to like my videos, and I'll be seeing you on this channel once a week, probably on Fridays, at least for the foreseeable future. As always, I hope that you are having adventures and following your dreams, and I will see you in the next one. Bye.